हेलो एवरीवन, टुडेज टॉपिक इज ग्रेविटेशन. ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इज नथिंग बट द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन टू ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड दे आर सेपरेटेड बाय अ डिस्टेंस विद नॉन जीरो मास. इन न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न दैट द फ्रूट एंड द अर्थ बोथ अप्लाई फोर्स विच इज हैविंग इक्वल मैग्नीट्यूड. बट If the forces are equal, then which one accelerate more? Of course, fruit will accelerate more. Because according to Newton's second law of motion, force applied is the product of mass and acceleration. It means F is equal to ma or A is equal to F by m. Or we can say that acceleration is inversely proportional to masses. If the acceleration is more, then mass will be less. Or if the mass is more, then acceleration will be less. As we know that the mass of the earth is very large as compared to the mass of the object, so the object will accelerate more. Now, to understand more about force, we have to understand first the universal law of gravitation. For that, we have to consider two objects A and B, and the distance between them is d. The distance which we consider here is not the distance between the object, but the distance from their center. Mass of object A is m1 and the mass of object B is m2. As the object A is bigger, so m1 is greater than m2. Universal law of gravitation state that every object in the universe attract every other object with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So we will get first equation, that is F is directly proportional to m1 m2, and from the second condition we will get F is inversely proportional to 1 by d square. Now after combining equation first and second, we will get the third equation. If the mass increases, the gravitational force also increases. And if the distance between the object is more, then there will be lesser gravitational force. It means F is directly proportional to m1 m2 upon d square. From the previous equation, we will get F is equal to G m1 m2 upon d square, and the value of G is 6.673 multiplied by 10 raised to the power minus 11 nm square kg raised to the power minus 2. The SI unit of G can be obtained by substituting the unit of force, distance and mass. And it was found out by Henry Cavendish by using a sensitive balance. So we will get at last G is equal to F d square m1 m2, which is called universal gravitational constant. I hope you have learned this concept very well. Thank you.